does he talk about climate change?
Climate change, I think, is a very hot topic for anybody and for everybody. And the Canary is one of the core areas of our work and one of our biggest programs. So climate change is an extremely important topic in the context of Trinidad and Tobago, of the Caribbean, of small islands. And I think, you know, if you think about what climate activist Greta Thunberg said recently, we must act as if our house is on fire. I think we really need to take action now. We are aware of all of the information, climate science is there, and we really need to start acting now. And so the work that Canary is doing is moving beyond education and awareness on climate change and focusing more on practical actions and how we can influence policy and also support others to advocate to address climate issues. I think we're doing quite a lot. The government has been working quite a lot in engaging other stakeholders, but I think we can do a lot more. And one of the biggest things that we need to do, and coming from a civil society organization, is that we need to ensure that civil society is being engaged more in climate change dialogue, in climate change actions, and so on. Has a big role to play. And I also think, for example, one specific action that we need, you know, I could draw an example to you, is, for example, the recent Escazú Agreement, which deals with access to information on environmental decision making, environmental justice, and so on. And really, it will allow civil society to have the tools and the information to be part of environmental decision making in the country. So, you know, there is a call to government right now to actually sign and ratify that agreement. So, those are the kinds of things that are supporting actions that could really contribute towards climate action in Trinidad and Tobago. So, one, continue to engage with society and increase engagement of civil society, and also pay attention to the agreements that are really going to make a difference and also allow civil society to play a role, such as the Escazú Agreement.
10 years ago, climate change would have just been something that was, you know, a daunting, you know, premonition for the future, as I would say, whereby we have advocates such as, let's say, Al Gore, for example, who's pushing this idea of what the effects of human beings' actions are, namely our emissions of carbon dioxide, the effects it would have on the environment, and naturally what the effects would have on us. You know, he called it the enhanced greenhouse gas effect, whereby you were producing all these greenhouse gases, namely carbon dioxide, that is contributing to warming the earth. So climate change essentially was looking at the effects of what this increased warming would do over a period of time, the changes would have on the climate and whatnot. But today, I think it has moved beyond just this, you know, terrifying premonition, more to reality. As we can see, we feel the effects of it. Today, you know, you go outside and the temperatures seem hotter, the days are hotter, you know, there's randomly in between these intense rainfall events that could lead to a lot of flooding. So, I mean, to me personally, Trinidad and Tobago climate change is a present reality that we face today and we will continue to face unless we make the necessary actions to change or to change our actions or what we are doing to contribute towards it.
What do you think are some of the more major effects that we are facing right now?
Wow, I can think back to last year where we had a major flood event in Trinidad and Tobago. I believe it was areas such as Orupun Gardens in Epiaco where under 3-4 feet of water, you know, there was intense rainfall for, I believe it was 2 days straight, and it created it almost had the country on standstill. So Trinidad and Tobago, we have been blessed or fortunate thus far not to experience major events such as or large scale hurricanes repeatedly year after year as our neighboring countries may face. But as we can see with climate change, this reality or blessing seems to be coming to an end, if so. So we are facing hotter temperatures, droughts, we are feeling effects with respect to agriculture. Farmers are complaining of water shortages to water the crops. We're facing effects such as I mentioned before, intense rainfall leading to floods, which can completely destroy farmers' yields over a period of time. you would notice an increase in vector-borne diseases, as you know, as temperatures increase, mosquitoes and the belt whereby they can exist has actually been increasing. So you have a lot of mosquitoes and these things propagating, which will carry stuff like the Aedes aegypti mosquito, which will carry diseases such as dengue fever. So I mean, it's something. There are a lot of issues that are being faced because of climate change that we can feel, as you know, within our day-to-day lives.
Okay. And do you think enough is being done by persons within the country?
Now, we can go from the top, come down. Okay. So on a national scale, you can always say more can be done, regardless of how much is being done, so long as there are still effects that you are feeling, and so long as there are contributions to the event or to climate change itself. So long as there are contributions towards it, you can say that more can be done. Currently, Trinidad has been doing a lot with respect to more in the lines of climate change mitigation. So within the topic of climate change, there's climate change mitigation and climate change adaptation. Mitigation looks at how we can reduce our greenhouse gas contributions, thereby contributing to or reducing our impact towards the warming. And then there's climate change adaptation, whereby how citizens or how the country as itself can adapt to the effects of climate change, be it from storm surges on your coastlines, be it from flooding, these sort of things. So within that framework, Trinidad and Tobago, so looking at climate change mitigation, for example, I discussed the carbon reduction strategy before, which was a pivotal moment in the country's history. Granted that Trinidad and Tobago is an oil-producing country, we'd have had the luxury of low energy costs because we are producing a lot of gas, which means persons tend to consume a lot of energy or a lot of petroleum, which again results in a large amount of greenhouse gases being emitted. And think globally or within the region, we are the second highest per capita contributor of greenhouse gas emissions, if I'm correct. And that being said, granted our small size, that says a lot of how much consumption is being done. So over the period of time, over the period of years, agencies such as the United Nations Development Programme would have worked in collaboration with the government, and in particular the Environmental Policy and Planning Division of the Ministry of Planning, to try and tackle these issues from the perspective that since we are an oil-producing country, we were more looking at how we can reduce our contribution to climate change. So there would have been a carbon reduction strategy. Coming out of that, there would have been a low emission capacity building programme, which would have had its phase one, which looked again took the framework of the carbon reduction strategy and tried to develop more concrete actions towards meeting our what we call the nationally determined contributions, which is basically our targets as to our reduction targets for greenhouse gas emissions. So from the LECB or low emission capacity building phase one, it would have graduated into phase two, which we are in right now, also known as the NDC support program, or the nationally determined contribution support program, which is trying to make more concrete plans towards implementing and looking at financial mechanisms to try and address the strategies that were outlined under phase one. So I mean, Trinidad and Tobago, we are taking steps. Other islands may say, you know, we aren't moving as quickly, or other islands, their focus may even be more towards adaptation because they would have been feeling the effects of hurricanes. So granted that we were fortunate not to feel a lot of effects from hurricanes, we were able to focus more on reducing our contributions. But granted that climate change is a present reality, certain steps need to be taken towards looking at adaptation strategies as well, how the country is going to adapt.